Let's say you're part of a team that spent years conducting research and preparing a manuscript to present your findings. Now you're ready to publish, and you'll need to make some big decisions, like what guidelines you want to set when it comes to sharing your work. You might be tempted to choose quickly, but the selection you make here will have a lasting impact on how your work is protected and how it can be shared, remixed, and reused. To set those guidelines, you choose from different licensing options, which fall on a spectrum, from restricted to wide open, with a range of Creative Commons licenses in between. All rights reserved is the most common option, but it may not be suitable for authors whose research is publicly funded. On the other hand, placing your work into the open public domain without any restrictions may not be a practical choice, since it increases the chance of your research being misrepresented. The flexibility of Creative Commons licensing allows your peers in the scientific community and the public at large varying levels of freedom to either reuse or excerpt your work. But Creative Commons does not have to be a giveaway of your valuable intellectual property. It can promote sharing while reserving certain vital protections. The level of Creative Commons most frequently used provides the most protection and allows your work to be reused freely, but stipulates 3 requirements. First, the report must be reproduced in its entirety, no derivatives in Creative Commons terms, eliminating the chance you'll be misquoted or taken out of context. Second, your work cannot be reused for commercial purposes. Finally, the person reusing your content must give you attribution, indicating that the content is by you. At the other end of the Creative Commons spectrum, you can use a CC BY and drop the non-commercial aspect, requiring only that others credit you for your work. While this gives reusers the greatest possible flexibility, it comes at a cost. With this license, it would be possible for the developer of this innovation to cherry-pick statements from your research to put a bias on the results to suit their own purposes. By pulling your findings out of context and crediting you, the developer could insinuate that you are making an endorsement. Between the two, this tier of Creative Commons license drops the no derivatives restriction, but still bars commercial reuse and requires that reusers credit you for your original work. For instance, university professors could incorporate excerpts from your study into their curriculum. Keep in mind, however, that you run the risk of having your work misquoted. Selecting the right licensing type is often a balancing act, but it's critical to safeguarding your work from misuse while delivering the greatest value to the community it serves.